This is the second part of quiz 3 from the spring of 2007. Okay, we have already calculated the incident electric and magnetic fields in general form. The third part of this, part C, is to address the power that is reflected. To do that most efficiently, let's actually solve part D first. Okay, in generic form. So the reflected electric field, reflected magnetic field, the transmitted electric field, and the transmitted magnetic field. Are written in most generic form as the reflection coefficient times E naught e to the plus j beta naught z. This is reflection coefficient E naught over eta naught, and there should be a minus sign in front of that, e to the plus j beta naught z. You notice the only real difference here is the direction of propagation indicated by the plus sign in the exponent and change in sign for h and the incorporation of the reflection coefficients. For the transmitted wave, all we have to do is multiply by tau and beta is going to be equal to beta naught square root of epsilon r. And then we'll have to come back and do this once we answer part C. Okay, so let's go up here to part C. So the reflected power, which is what we were given there, says 15% of the incident power is reflected. So the reflected power is going to be 150, and that will equal reflection coefficient times E naught squared over 2 eta naught. And this is telling us that this is the reflected power is equal to 0.15 times 1000. Therefore, the reflection coefficient squared is 0.15, which tells us the reflection coefficient is either plus or minus 0.3875. And generically, this looks like eta 2 minus eta 1 over eta 2 plus eta 1. And remember, we don't really know the sign yet unless we look now at this expression and decide what the sign should be. Okay, so if eta 2 is less than eta 1, which would be the case when we're going from air to a dielectric, then reflection coefficient is negative, since for realistic dielectric, the eta 2 must always be less than eta naught because epsilon r is greater in the dielectric. So the reflection coefficient is equal to minus 0.3875. And we will continue this in the next lecture.